Hello guys, Susie Cod here and welcome back to Star Stable. I have taken out my starter horse because it's been a while since we have used him, and I also got a comment on my previous episode that it was a while since we had our starter horse. So I'm totally agree, and that's why we have our starter horse today. Today we're gonna continue on this thief mystery or something like that. A thief is going loose in Moorland, and we are pretty sure that there is someone from Dark Court. So we have done some work together with this nasty character, and I don't like it. So today we're gonna continue the quest, and I see we have the updated quest over here. Okay, nasty character, what is your plan?
Quiet and listen to me. I just got the word that the thief has already struck. He's breaking into the lighthouse right now. If we hurry there, we might be able to catch him red-handed. Quick, to the lighthouse.
The crook jumps up behind you on your horse and points up towards the lighthouse above the beach.
Quick, ride. Ride like the wind.
Oh gosh, he's so big. Poor horse. Not very fan of having him behind, or on my horse at all. I have a bad feeling. Easy there. Oh, here we have the lighthouse. Ah! Okay, what now?
Looks like we made it. Stay quiet now. He's probably still inside the lighthouse. The thief must be in there. Hey, sneak in and see if you can open the door without making any noise. If you manage that, I will jump in and grab him. Careful now. Creep up to the door and focus on opening it completely silently. We don't want to scare him off now we have got this close.
True, but still, I'm not so fan of this, though. Just walk. Do not run. I will be right back, Phantom Blaze. You stay there with the nasty character. Oh no! Something is coming behind us! No! Turn around! Turn around! Oh. Smack! Something hits your head. You feel yourself faint, everything turns black.
Hello? Are you awake?
Mrs. Holdsworth! What am I doing here? What's up in the lighthouse? Just recently.
Hello? Are you awake? Stella? Hello there, how's your head? Let's have a look at you. Nope, seems like you have passed the worst of it. Seems like you all have a bit of a bump there for a while, but it will go down. What are you doing here, you ask? Well, let's see. I heard an almighty crash up at the lighthouse a while ago. So I went up there to see what's going on. I found the door off its hinges and you on the ground, completely out of the account and impossible to reach. I carried you down here. You carried me down all here. What? You carried me down from the lighthouse?
Mrs. Holdsworth, you were strong.
Where was I? Carried you down here and let you get some rest in peace and quiet. A few hours rest and the weapons from one of my famous herbal brews seems to have done the trick. One thing that was rather strange, Stella, when I found you up there at the lighthouse, you had one of Joe's trophies in your hand, one of the ones that were stolen a little while back. You're not a thief, are you, Stella?
No, promise.
You have no idea how Joe's trophy made into your hand? I believe you, Stella. You did never do a thing like that.
I think there's someone trying to pin the blame of these thefts in Morlin on you. Probably the actual thief trying to get away with it. You were lucky it was me who found you, because it wouldn't have been difficult to explain to the police why you had stolen goods on you if they found you. But one question. Why were you up in the lighthouse in the first place? Was that? You rode there with some crooked character from the beach to try and stop the thief? Uh-huh. Seems quite clear what's going on here, then. That shady character who went with you up to the lighthouse must have been the thief. When you started asking difficult questions, he must have tried to get rid of you and get away with all at the same time. A crafty plan. If I hadn't heard all that commotion and noise from the lighthouse, it would have worked. Probably the best that you ride down to Dark Horse Camp as quick as you can and confront that thief before he gets away.
Yeah. What on earth did happen?
Okay, where is that nasty character?
Hey, you! You don't get... Oh, shifty character. Oh no, where is the nasty character?
Thief? Why are you saying I'm bastard? No point playing dumb, you say? What are you talking about and who are you? Hold on a minute. You seem to think you're talking to my predecessor. The guy who was standing here just a couple of hours ago. Well, you're not. Talking to him, that is. That much I can tell you. He was hastily replaced about half an hour ago. Disappeared on one of our ships. The last I saw of him was that he was running off onto the ship. Quicker than a rat up a drying pipe. He didn't look like he had time to pack either. He had nothing with him when he left. Now you can get lost. I haven't got time to talk to you. Beat him. What? Stolen goods? I don't know what you're talking about. Sounds interesting though. Probably best I take a look at my predecessor's belongings. He disappeared so fast that all his things are left there on the boat. Excuse me in one second. I will go and investigate at once. If I find anything interesting, I will let you know. You can rely on me.
Yeah, right.
What's that? If you don't get to take a look for yourself, you will call the police?
Okay.
Go through his stuff yourself then. You have to promise not to call the police though.
Promise?
This isn't something to joke about. Now you have promised. My predecessor kept his things in a wooden box on the boat over there by the radio equipment.
Oh, there we have the box. Let's see what we can find.
We found a wristwatch.
Empty pie tray.
Small hammer. How are you saying? And trophies. I knew it. We found what we were looking for. Did you find these things? They were stolen goods, you say? If they really are stolen goods, then the only fingerprints on them now are yours. Here at Dark Core, we all wear gloves. If I remember rightly, you had all these things with you when you arrived. Maybe I would just call the police myself and tell them I caught the thief. Maybe you can just give me all the loot and we can forget all this ever happened. What do you say?
What? You think I should call the police?
You are sure they would take your word over mine?
Okay, you win this time.
Haha. You beat me this time, but I'm not as dumb as the last guy. We will meet again. You can be sure of that.
Oh gosh, he's one scary, shifty character.
Grr, the smell of all that baking from that old granny's house is so good. If my predecessor hadn't taken that pie, I did have done it myself. Hey, listen, give the pie case back to the old dear and maybe she will set out another pie to cool sometime soon. Then I will be ready and waiting. Now get out of here and take this junk with you.
Mrs. Holdsworth, we have found the stolen goods.
Hello, Stella. Oh, that looks like my pie tin.
Some crook down there wanted you to give it back to me so he can steal the next pie I bake. You know what, Stella? I will be making my super extra double ultra volcano spicy chili pie. Oh gosh, that will be burning inside his mouth. I baked it only once before, and it was for the final of that reality show, Jorvik's Biggest Dummy, where the first person to eat a whole piece of the pie won the contest and got 1,000,000 Jorvik shillings. That was the first year that there were no winners at all.
Wow, Mrs. Holdsworth.
Oh, a teeny timer. There we go. A teeny hammer finds its home. The awesome watch is back. Trophies are no joke. This teeny hammer must belong to Conrad. Give it back to him, Stella. I heard he was a little depressed last time you spoke to him, so he could probably use the good news.
True.
This must be Tan's watch. Probably best you give it back to her, but you can tell her from me there will be no more pie for her in the future.
Agree.
Here are all of Joe's trophies. Hurry now and give them back to him. He'll be so happy to get them back. The little angel.
Thank you, Mrs. Holdsworth. I will. Conrad, we have a hammer for you.
I spy with my little eye something begin with my tiny hammer. I thought it was lost forever. Thank you, Stella. Your heroics will not be forgotten.
Anytime.
I thought it was my own fault the hammer was gone, and that my memory was fading and that my old age was finally getting the better of me. But now everything's in order and all back to normal. All thanks to you, Stella. I have never lost a tool in my life, and it won't happen again anytime soon. I swear it. Just as surely my name is Conrad Marston. Stella, hurry now and give Jenna the incredible news. She doesn't need to cry anymore. Her flower pots are going to be finished by sundown.
Tan, we have your watch. Be nicer, or be nice to Mrs. Holdsworth from now on, because there will be no pie for you.
Hey, Stella. What's up? What? No way! My watch, for real? Hey, Loretta, check it out! My amazing new watch is back! Isn't it gorgeous? Awesome! You are, like, totally jealous now, huh? Hey, Loretta, I was just joking. You can borrow it anytime you like. Seriously, we're besties. BFFs forever and ever. For real, you know? Oh gosh, okay.
Special!
Thanks, Stella. This is amazing. Can't believe you found the watch so fast. Tell Jenna that Loretta and I aren't thieves if she hadn't already figured that by herself. Now I need to go.
Ciao. Josh, trophies are no joke.
Hey, Stella. Life is just so boring without my trophies. I never thought they meant that much to me, but I guess you don't know what you have got until it's gone. What? What's that you say? You found my trophies? You're kidding! Don't joke about this, Stella. No way! Let me see! My trophies! Oh yeah, my babies! I never thought I didn't see them again. Thanks so much, Stella. You're amazing.
Aw, thank you.
Greetings from Happy Champion. Stella, this day got off to a terrible start, but ended brilliantly. You need to tell Jenna that all my trophies are back. She'll be delighted too.
Jenna, we have found all the stolen goods.
My flower pots are almost finished. Good of Conrad to let me know. Now I suppose I just need some flowers to put in them. Wow. Tan got her watch back, you say? I guess she was happy about that. Nice. Now I don't have to listen to any more of hers and Loretta's whining. For a while, at least.
True.
Josh got his trophies back? Then I guess he will be pretty happy right now. How nice. It felt horrible to see such a good guy like Josh be so sad. Good work, Stella.
Thank you.
Stella, thank you so much for helping us put a stop to all this theft here in Moreland. You didn't just find the thief, but you also got back all the stuff that was stolen. Josh, Tan, Mrs. Holdsworth, and Grant Marston have all asked me to find an appropriate award for your heroism.
Wow, thank you.
I don't know quite what it could be, though. Something to suit you. Actually, yeah, wait, I know. Jenna looks in a box behind her. Jenna grabs something from the box behind her. Here you go, Stella. What do you think? Maybe it's not much considering all you have done, but I hope you like it. Take care, Stella. See you soon. What have we got? Wow, that helmet is so beautiful and the color of it. Oh, gosh. Love it. Okay, let's continue with Jenna here. Hey, Stella. Have you heard that we have got a new horse at Morlin Stables?
Oh.
The horse belongs to Maya's cousin, but Maya promised to take care of him for a few days. I have gotten no idea what Maya's cousin is called. Oh, right. You mean what's the horse name? I'm afraid I don't know that either. Phoenix? Spinix? Nah, Blinks? Nope. Jinx? Nah, I can't remember. What I do know is that he's so cheeky and adorable. You and Phantom Blade should stop by and say hello before he goes home again. Like I said, I don't know how long he will be here, but talk to Maya. She knows him more. Okay, thank you. Let's greet his new horse. Maya, I heard there's a new horse here. Oh no, 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 no. Oh no, what's going on? What do you want? I haven't got time to talk. Maya, chill. I'm sorry, Stella. I didn't mean to be mean, but it's a chaos here right now. Total chaos. A new horse? That's right. Well, not so much new. More, I'm just looking after my cousin's horse, Lynx, for a few days. Really though, I'd love to stay and chat, but I have got a little, or actually a massive problem. The three horses that are usually here seems to have run away. Oh. Seriously though, you're not gonna believe what happened. I did just take Lynx into the stable when something went wrong. I don't know if he was scared or just was causing a fuss or whatever. Anyway, he managed to freak all the horses out, and in all the fuss, one of them kicked over a glass bowl that was laying on the floor. So, not only do we have three runaway horses, but the whole place is covered in bits of glass. Great, huh? As luck will have it, Josh helped out. He took Lynx with him away from here so I could get on with clearing up all the glass and look out for the other horses. Why was there a glass bowl in the stables? Well, yeah, that was my fault. I brought it with me to give it to Jenna. She saw it in a picture I uploaded to Instacam and fell in love with it. Since I had two of the same, I thought I could give her one of them. That was nice of you, Maya. When Lynx arrived, I needed to put it down pretty fast, and then there was all a distraction, so I didn't have a chance to put it anywhere safe. Ugh, why do I have to be so stupid? I should have been more careful. I guess there's not much I can do about it now, though. The most important thing is that to get rid of all this glass so that nobody gets hurt. You want to help? Aw, thanks so much, how lovely. Take the brush over by the wall behind me and sweep up the little shards of glass in the stable while I take care of the glass that got outside. Be careful though, and make sure you and Phantom Blaze don't cut yourselves. These little splinters of glass can be really sharp. Okay then I will let Phantom Blaze be out here while I go in and sweep the glass. Ooh, yeah, they look pretty sharp to me. There we go, Maya. Now all the glass is gone. Is all the glass in the stable gone now? Yes. Thanks so much, Stella. I think we go up on our horse. So the camera will be a bit easier. How nice that we have cleaned up all the bits of glass. Imagine getting one of them stuck in your foot. Ugh, I get the shivers just thinking about it. Same. Now we need to get the horses home as well. They can't have got too far. Oh, why do I have to be so clumsy, Stella? Will you be able to ride out and look for them? Sure. You have already got Phantom Blaze all settled and ready. Thanks, seriously. I owe you for this. No problem. I help you anytime.
Take these sugar lumps with you. Use them to get the runaway horses to follow you home. I will. Alright. Can see. Oh, here we have one. Oh, how beautiful are you? Come on, little horsey. Let's get home. And where are you living? In the middle here? I think so. Yep. First horse back. Next one. Hello, horsey. Let's get you back. Come on. Into the stable. Number two. Where's number three? Ooh. Here we have it. Come on. Back to the stable. Alright. Last one. Here we go. All the horses are back, ma'am. Phew. Great. Now all the horses are back. Thanks ever so much for your help. You really saved the day. Excellent, you found all the horses! Of course, we need to check the horse's hooves and make sure they didn't pick up any glass in there. If they did, then they could get a pretty horrible injury. I'm so nervous, I can hardly look. Stella, you seem to have remarkably sharp vision. Like a wonderful eagle, could you please look at the hooves? Of course, Maya. Thanks. I really, really, really hope there's nothing in there. Here, take my hoof pick and brush. That way you can check them out nice and gently. Okay. No glass splinters. Good. No glass splinters. Very good. Last one. Fingers crossed. No! Poor thing! Oh no. Maya, I have some bad news. One of the horses got some glass splinters in the hoof. No! Seriously? Really? Oh, one of the horses got some glass in the hoof? Oh, the poor thing. Yeah. Oh, I'm so annoyed with myself. I should have just given the ball straight to Jenna, or at least put it down in a safer place. Oh well, what can we do? We will have to help the poor thing somehow. I know, Mrs. Holdsworth has a special ointment that's almost magic. I've used it before. You just rub it in where you have been injured, and it helps ease any pain, stops infection. Helps the healing process as well. I have never used the ointment on a horse, but would you be able to ride over and ask her for some so we can give it a try? Sure. Awesome, thanks, Stella. While you're off getting the ointment, I will look after this poor thing and clean out his hoof. It must be so painful for him. Yeah, I think so too. Mrs. Holdsworth, we have another problem. Good day, Stella. You need an ointment, you say?
Yeah, a horse is injured.
Oh no! What's what you say? One of the horses at the stable has stepped on glass splinter? Poor thing. Yes, I do have a recipe for a healing ointment. If you help me get the ingredients together, I can make a batch for you. I don't have the recipe to hand, but if I remember rightly, we will need beach crocuses. Okay. The beach crocuses grows by the water and has small pretty pink flowers. Ride down to the beach behind my house and take a look there. If you get started with the flowers, I will look for the recipe and see what else we need. Okay, Mrs. Holdsworth, we will do. Small pink flowers. Ooh, bright pink. Good job, you found three beach crocuses. They are not easy to find, I know. Sometimes it's taken me hours to find just one. While you were away, I found the recipe for the ointment Maya asked for.
My grandma wrote it down for me after I managed to cut myself on a sharp rock when I was swimming in the lake. That was a while ago now, though. Nope. Enough old memories. Now let's get to work. I have got beach crocuses, so what else do we need now? Dandelions. We need dandelions. Can we get some dandelions? We need dandelions. Dandelions, Stella. While you get the dandelions, I will prepare these beach crocuses.
Okay. Oh. Seven. Okay.
I got them all, Mrs. Holdsworth. That was fast. Now I just need to mix up the ointment. It could take a while, but I know it's urgent and Maya needs it as soon as possible. If you just hold on a little while.
Well, that was fast too, Mrs. Holdsworth.
There, the ointment is finished. Take it to Maya and let her know that she should clean the hoof thoroughly before applying the ointment. Otherwise, it won't work properly.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Holdsworth.
We can always count on you
for, like, everything.
We have got the ointment, Maya. Stella! Did you get hold of the ointment?
Yes, I did.
Awesome! Now I can take care of this little sickie right here.
Thanks for all your help, Stella. It was a total chaos here, for real. And you helped. All because Lynx was...
Lynx! I totally forgot about him!
This is really unlike me. I need to get to Josh. He was so kind to offer to look after Lynx, and now I have just taken advantage. I should go and see him right now, but I have got to stay here and take care of this poor fellow with his sore hoof. Please, Stella, could you go to Josh and get Lynx? Conrad Marston, the blacksmith, had promised to reshoe Lynx for me, so it did be awesome if you could take him there afterwards. Please? It'd be incredibly if you could.
Nice!
Thanks so much. I seriously owe you one after all this.
Anytime, Maya. But with that, we are actually out of time, so we need to greet Lynx in the next episode and see how he looks like. So yeah, what do you guys think about this chief mystery? It was very special, especially when we get hit in the head. That was... ouch. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to greet Lynx or see how Lynx's look like in the next episode. Let me know what you guys think about today's episode and about especially this poor horse that stepped on glass splinters. That cannot be very good. So yeah, we will continue with this quest in the next episode. So give a thumbs up if you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!